all of self kind of things. Like there is no outside, so outside turning in, realizing all is within. All right, back checking out some more Tool. 46 and 2. We haven't heard too many Tool songs yet, so we're still trying to get the hang of it. Let's get into it. Did you hear those whispers?
No.
You couldn't make them out?
No, I don't know what it said.
Yeah, me either. Okay, I think we absolutely need a lyric video. Yeah. Back with the DMT art. That little snippet was talking about the shadow. So I guess this song is going to be about the shadow.
Okay.
This is a lyrics video, so I mean, I don't think that was included in it. But the picture that's on the screen, I feel like that is the most classic.
Yeah, it is.
The most classic.
Yeah.
Like DMT art picture kind of thing.
Yeah, it is.
Like that is just the epitome of it. And it's a very good picture. I feel like it's the most popular, most classic picture for a reason.
And it's like tunnels upon tunnels upon... That's really accurate.
Right. So my question to you is, have you ever experienced or seen anything similar to the picture that's on the screen? Let us know in the comments.
Yeah.
Okay, he said, join me or join my child digging through my old numb shadow. So 46 and 2 is about to be a song and he's taking us through his shadow. What?
Yeah.
This is about to be crazy.
What if he was 46 years old and there was two of him and he's about to address the both of them?
Two of him? What?
Yeah, like his shadow and his non-shadow.
Oh, okay.
And he's 46 years old and he's about to go through his life. In two.
I don't know, but I can't wait to hear the song.
Okay, let's go.
I love the whole Carl Jung in the shadow type stuff. I like that stuff. So I definitely want to hear
it. Yeah.
Okay, so he said he's down digging through his muscles and whatnot, looking for, I think he said clues or something, right? He's digging through his muscles. And I find that line very interesting because when you do shadow work, like you will have like random muscle twitches.
Oh,
you know?
Yeah,
you know?
That's so true.
Like you would just muscle be twitching, boom, boom, boom. So I was like, oh, snap. Mm-hmm. And what does he do, this digging through his muscles thing? That's exactly where my mind went when he said digging through his muscles.
That's so true.
Illusion for a beast to cross me over, for a word to guide me in. I wanna feel the shakers coming down.
I love that. I love that. That break, that ramp up with the electric guitar, and then he was like, shut up! Oh, I love it. I love it. Oh, interesting song.
Right, I can't wait to get more into it. Talking about picking through, picking his scabs again. So I'm guessing he's integrating his shadow.
What do you mean?
Integrating the shadow aspect of himself. Like, the traits that...
Accepting it?
Yes. Like, the traits that we as people like to repress, you know, and suppress and pretend don't exist. So I guess he's digging through himself and he's integrating his shadow.
He wants to know what he's hiding.
I think so. I think that's what he's getting at. This is a whole psychology lesson. When he said he wants to feel the outside turning in.
Okay.
That made me think like, okay, well, your shadow, you'll project a lot of those things onto people, right? Okay. Things that are truly like traits that are in your shadow.
Okay.
Like you'll get triggered by those things and project it onto people.
Yeah.
So he's saying he wants that to turn from projection towards like introspection.
Acceptance, introspection. Okay.
I feel like that's what he's getting at, you know? Feel the outside turning in.
Oh.
Or maybe it's on some different kind of infinite being type energy to where there is no outside.
Oh.
Maybe that. No, it could be that. You know what I mean? Like, all is self kind of things. Like, there is no outside. So, outside turning in, realizing all is within. Or it could be the whole go from projection to, like, introspection. Could be either or. That's where I am right now. How about you?
My shadow! That's where I'm at. I love it.
You love that part.
I love it. Okay, I got a question for you.
Mm-hmm.
So those whispers, you know how he'll start whispering and then he'll like build it up until he's like, listen to my, like he'll like build it up.
Mm-hmm.
Do you experience whispers like that in certain dimensions?
Ooh. Ooh. I mean, now that you mention it. Yes.
Right?
Definitely.
So specific.
But, I mean, a whisper, it's hard to describe.
Hard to describe.
I wouldn't exactly describe it as a whisper.
It's not audible.
Right, but I would say it's not very like loud, at least what I've experienced.
Yeah.
I don't know. I feel like other people may have experienced all kind of different things, but from what I've experienced, the things I hear are never like very loud, you know?
Right.
It's almost as if it's like an internal voice kind of thing. I don't know, it's weird.
Right.
What is this 46 and 2?
Right.
I feel like we should know what that means. It made me think of 23 and 1, like Silas Harry can find me, like 23 and 1, like 46 and 2.
Oh, you're genius.
That's what it made me think of.
I bet it's related to that. If you double that solitary confinement, so it's like solitary, like.
You know what I mean? It would be like 2 days of solitary confinement, 46 and 2. That's just what made me think of. I have no clue, like what he's talking about.
I didn't know.
That was the only like parallel I could draw.
I feel like you're really close, because it's double that. So double solitary confinement. Maybe it's literally double solitary.
A 2-day trip. I don't know.
No, I mean, like, maybe it's like...
spending 2 days in isolation, going within kind of thing.
No, like double solitary.
But it's just double the time. It's not double the punishment. You know what I mean?
Two. Oh,
right,
oh,
but I see. It would be 2 days if that was hours.
Yeah, I don't know. Okay.
right, so this, the first kind of human has a chromosome composition 42+2. They comprise a unity of consciousness that does not see anything outside themselves as separate from themselves. Okay, so the outside would be inside, like nothing separate, you know? Like this type of consciousness. This is interesting because we're doing the lyric video. Like, this is not part of the song.
Right.
So it's interesting. Like, it's a little distracting.
It is.
It's a little, like, taken away from the song, but it's also helping. Adding. Yeah.
Yeah.
They interpreted 42 and 2.
But I'm thinking it's prison stuff. And 2.
True.
So they're probably going to say the first kind of human, because they're saying first kind of human, nothing separate. So I'm thinking, like, what, animal consciousness or, like, bacteria consciousness?
No, this is humans.
Oh, first kind of human.
That feel the unity. So there's probably another kind of human that doesn't. Feels we're all separate, completely individual little globs of, like, bacteria.
Now I'm interested to see what kind of...
Right. So it is a little distracting, but it also is adding, so I actually am glad we have it up. We are a disharmonic level of consciousness that is used as a stepping stone from the 42 and 2 level to the next level, 46 and 2. Okay. Those two additional chromosomes change everything. So, and that's the quote that this is by the guy that it's by.
Okay.
I am still a little confused on this 46 and 2 business. So the 46 and 2 human is disharmonic. I guess just doesn't realize the unity of all things or something like that. It's disharmonic, I'm thinking. You know what I mean? It's a 42 and 2, like they realize the connectedness of everything.
Right.
So I wonder how this relates to the shadow thing. I guess you can't project from your shadow of everything itself, you know, if everything's connected. Because, I mean, I'm very familiar with shadow work and Carl Jung teachings and all that kind of stuff, right? I've never heard of the 42 and 2 and 46 and 2.
Right.
Never heard of that. So I wonder how it relates to the shadow. Because from what I learned about the shadow stuff, it was per individual, and then within the like shadow diagram thing, you have the collective consciousness aspect of it, you know what I mean? But for the individual, it's like stuff you're repressing your shadow, and then the stuff that you claim is identified with basically as your traits, you know?
Right. But I guess if you have like unified consciousness, you can't really have a shadow if you are everything. Like, for example, I like watched this North Korean defector on YouTube, and she was saying that in North Korea, they're not taught I. Like, there is no, like, I. Like, everything you do, everything you like, you say, we like this. We do this. We feel this way. And so she said when she left North Korea, learning the concept of I and, like, the separation was, like, mind-blowing.
But even though they don't learn the concept of I in North Korea, do they feel, like, a universal consciousness kind of thing?
Well, I don't think so.
Right?
But I think that they don't...
Because I don't think they're going to be like, oh, we're going to the palace today because I'm hungry. You know what I mean? If it's all, you know what I mean? I don't think it's like that it's all connected.
Right. It's not the same as the Aboriginals' way of like with nature and everything. But
Right.
I still think that there is a certain, like, you're taught separation.
Right. I think so. Well, I mean, babies don't even know they're separate from their mother
Yeah, that's
until
right.
such and such an age. I don't remember the age, but when you're first born, you literally don't know you're a separate being.
Remember that experiment? I forget the video, but remember it was
I
like
know exactly what you're talking about.
the babies, yeah, they were like pushing a shopping cart, and like they would stand a baby on like this like piece of material tied to the shopping cart, and it was like up until like 2 years old or something, the baby didn't realize by standing on it they were preventing the shopping cart from moving. But they like didn't understand the like separation.
Yeah, so I want to know how this 42 and 2, 46 and 2,
Ties
relates
into this.
to the shadow.
Yeah, me too.
But I guess if you
He said 46 and 2 ahead of me.
right. So I'm a little confused on the 46 and 2 and 42 and 2. But I guess if you're a 42 and 2 type of person, you wouldn't have a shadow.
If you're 46 and 2, how is that ahead of him though? What does that mean? Like,
I
because
don't
he's
know because I don't fully understand what
old.
46 and 2 is.
He's going through the shadow. So, like, I don't know.
Is
I thought I had it
46
for a
and 2
second.
like the next evolution of the human being, or is it a regression? I don't know because I don't fully understand what 46 and 2 is.
Sounds like a regression, but
Or is it a necessary step
true.
to
'Cause
get
it's
to
like
another level?
unified consciousness. It's like that seems good, but it's also the Aboriginals and stuff. It's like there's only a certain level of like understanding of stuff they can get with like.
But it's all stuff. So, you know, it's all kind of
It
meaningless.
is.
It's like, yeah, I mean, we could say our way of life is better than theirs, but it depends what your goals are in life. If your goal is to be happy, our way of life might not be. I bet we're more but we're more stressed out than they are. You know what I mean? So it's just two different ways of life. But I mean, I don't know who's to say one's better or worse. That's why it's hard to say, is this a evolution or
Right, or devolution.
right?
That's so true. And oh, there was one other part I had a question about. He was talking about the like shedding his skin. Oh, he said soften his armor. I thought that was interesting.
Why so?
Cause like by having a shadow, I definitely feel that the armor is thick. You
Right.
know, it's like
Very
hard.
thick.
It's hard to get through, and it's like, yeah, you're protected from the outside world, but you're also like, you're sort of defenseless against yourself almost. Like you're kind of like, you know what I'm trying to say? Like you're
Right.
basically you got a wall up with yourself too, so you're gonna be living like sort of split psychology.
Oh yeah. The most interesting thing about the shadow stuff to me is
What?
once you learn about the shadow, right?
Okay.
Then you realize there are people who don't know they have a shadow. That is the most interesting thing, is once you learn about your shadow and you're like, dang, whoo, all that stuff I've been accusing everyone else of, I need to look within, but whoops, you know what I
And it is like softening, like it's warm and
Right.
squishy, and it's scary to deal with, but it feels good.
But then when people don't know they have a shadow, then their shadow is going to be even
Huge.
darker, even bigger. You know, and I always find it interesting to like interact with people who have no clue that they too have a shadow.
Because I feel like they'll think their self-awareness is like, you know, oh, I'm such a good person, and like I'm just, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm doing everything right.
I
And then it's
know
like
what you're
you
saying.
can just observe that person. And it's like with your perspective, you can just like see so much that they don't realize that you're seeing, that they think they're hiding from,
But you
you
can't
know what I
say
mean?
anything because it's going to trigger something within them that's being repressed.
Yeah.
And so
Ritual.
it's always interesting. And I don't mean interesting in a condescending way. I mean it's literally
It's literally
interesting.
fascinating.
Yeah, it is.
It is. Because, like, how people, it's almost like we all have this, like, way we want to be perceived, but then, like, the bigger the shadow, the more, like, drastically different how you truly are versus how you, like, you know what I mean?
Right,
There's, like, two different
right.
people, and it's like you can just watch that in action. It's very crazy.
Yeah, but that's all I have on this one. I love stuff like this.
Yeah, I feel like we're gonna
Like the more
love.
introspective kind of stuff.
It's right up
Especially when you
there.
get to like some dimensionality kind of stuff. Like, ooh, you got me. You
This is
got me. I'm
like,
hooked.
this
You
is
know
your
what
zone. This is
I
like, I feel like if we had not done this channel and like, you know, seen this music and stuff, eventually you would have found something like this and like been like, look at this, Lex.
Maybe. I would have never found this music. Now I don't even know how to find it.
But I
It's
mean,
never gonna pop up on my feed. Like, if people didn't recommend it, I would have never seen this in my whole life. Never.
Probably not. But I feel like you're this the whole all of it. Psychedelic sort of introspection, transcendental, that's all you.
Yeah, I like what you're gonna say.
That's amazing.
Yeah, that's all I have on this one.
That's all I got. All
right, thanks for kicking it on the couch with us. Shout out to the Discord Couch Gang for this recommendation.
Shout out.
Yeah, definitely.
That's where this came from, dang.
Definitely glad we found a tool. But yeah, if you want to help grow the Couch Gang, could like the video, comment, subscribe to the channel, all that kind of stuff. All that kind of stuff helps us grow the channel. We appreciate all the support. If you want to join the Discord, links in the description. It's totally free. So we'd love to have you there. We can continue this conversation. We talk about all kind of stuff in Discord. But we appreciate you. Thank you for watching, supporting the channel, especially if you made it to the end. That's a wrap.
I don't know. Tell me, man, what do you know?
What do you know?
Me and my boys on the road. Here we go. She told me, boy, you the go. Like, I don't know. But I don't know.